The Philippines' second warship acquired from the United States makes its first port call in San Diego, California. It's sailing to Hawaii and Guam before finally coming home in the first week of August. More from our North America Bureau correspondent, Steve Angeles.
The crown jewel of the Philippines Navy is on its way to the Philippines, the BSR Ramon Alcaraz PF-16. The ship was acquired from the U.S. Coast Guard in 2012 and underwent renovations and testings for the past year. The 378-foot-long battleship is equipped with twin diesel engines and a cannon, with a maze inside, but also the comforts of home, with Filipino cooking on board and barakbayan boxes full of gifts from the Filipino community in South Carolina, where the ship departed from last month.
Ito ay kagaya ng BRP Gregorio del Pilar. Ito ay kanyang sister ship. At sa current inventory natin ngayon, ito ay ang dalawang barko na ito ay pinakamalaking barko ng sa inventory ng Philippine Navy.
It's the second ship the U.S. has given to the Philippines in the past 2 years as the Philippine military continues to upgrade its fleet. Upon receiving it, President Aquino asked that this ship be named after a Filipino naval hero. And his research team dug up World War II hero and Philippine Military Academy graduate Commodore Ramon Alcaraz, who passed away 4 years ago. The Alcaraz family is now based in Southern California and came to visit the ship.
I'm so happy. I'm so happy.
Yeah.
And he must be smiling up there.
The PF-16 will patrol the seas surrounding the Philippines, including the West Philippine Sea, where the Philippines and China are caught in a territorial dispute.
Hindi lang sa Spratly, kundi sa buong lugar ng Pilipinas kung saan nangangailangan ng presence ng malaking barko.
The PF-16 will leave San Diego on Friday, taking a three-week journey to the Philippines with brief stops in Hawaii and Guam. When it arrives in Subic, it will get a new paint job before it's commissioned and activated for duty. The Ramon Alcaraz has 88 crew members on board right now, all of them familiar and well-trained with the ship after spending the past year in South Carolina undergoing exercises. The crew is expected to expand to over 100 when it's in the Philippines. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, San Diego.
And we're taking a break coming up on the Bureau.